You released a great hand is what's special.
That's a great point, and I noticed that too. The thing that jumps out at me about Bryce Young is he does the small things, the little things very well. He's extremely poised and composed in the pocket, but for a young quarterback, for him to pay attention to the small details, that lets me know that this guy's game is on another level. Let me show you exactly what I'm talking about. This is what the Gators defense is going to have to contend with today. Forever Young. Now watch him. As the motion goes to his right, he's keeping his eyes down the field. He feels the pressure. His first read is gone. His second read is gone. He doesn't panic. He slides up into the pocket, keeps his eyes down the field, both hands on the ball, and he throws the ball to John Metchie III. Metchie's going to do the rest. He's an excellent runner after the catch. But because that Bryce Young kept his eyes down the field, just felt the pressure, he's able to make that play happen. Watch this. Watch his hips right here. He understands he's about to go to the right. Rewind it. Watch his hips and his feet. Boom. Gives himself a chance to rip that ball out there to the sideline. This is why I love. The protection is going to his left because he knows the pressure's coming there. Look at the offensive line. They're communicating. Perfect. Watch Bryce Young. He understands he's about to get heat. What does he do? He slides a little bit to his right to give his tight end, Cameron Latou. That's his hot read right there on the blitz. Give him a chance to just hook up over the center. Boom. Throw it to him and let Cameron do the rest. A touchdown. For him to know where the blitz is coming from, and then to also understand what's his hot read and slide just to give himself some time so the route can develop, tells me that this guy's football IQ is on another level. Very impressed what I've seen so far from Bryce Young, David.
Here we go again.
Yes,
another
sir.
Bama team comes in and they just, hey, we got to score 30. So I'm interested. I think in the tape there, if we went back and listened, I think Florida said that they had the best defensive front in the nation.
Mm.
I believe that's what I heard. I haven't seen that yet from Florida. And last year, this Florida defense didn't look anything like Florida we've seen in a number of years.
Yeah.
They looked embarrassing at times. So you feel that? You believe that? I love you say it with your chest. You better go back it up on the field because I'm interested to see because I feel like that's the weakness of Florida.
Don't talk about it. Be about it.
Yeah. Florida leads the nation in rushing offense. 763 yards. That's important because it's the first time in the first two games that that has happened in 25 years.
Wow.
Now, listen, they're led by a quarterback, Anthony Richardson. Remember his name. He's a future superstar. Now, if Florida can keep the ball away from the Tide offense and keep them on the sideline, they got a chance for an upset. Easier said than done, sweetheart.
Easier said than done. Anthony Richardson is not only the future, his future may start today. Because his ability to run and throw. I don't know if Florida's going to be able to run the football. You know, we've talked a lot about Chris Allen being out. Will Anderson got dinged. Now we're going to see, I think Will Anderson looks like he's going to be okay. He's been cleared. It's more of a mindset for him to overcome that injury. Will Anderson, he's known as a pass rusher. But if you watch him play, and I know David really appreciates this, being a pass rush guy himself, it's when he moves to the inside at the 4-I, and the inside where the offensive linemen are, this dude is pushing people. He's 243 pounds, but his hands and how explosive he is, he pushes 300-pounders back into the backfield, blows the play up, and then is able to help the linebackers make a play. So Miami thought, man, there's a lot to deal with his speed. Let's try to get a numbers advantage. We got 3-on-1 to the outside. We can run the ball, but they got even numbers there. So let's just get it outside real quick. Look how quick this back-end Alabama defense plays. That play was designed to be able to easily get to the outside, but they blow it up. Here again, this is a quarterback power with 4-on-3 to the top. 0.3 Alabama defenders. This should be made for the offense to get yards. Not only does Malachi Moore get off, look at all the defense flying to the football and how quickly they're able to get there. And then you have this, goal line stand, who gets off the fastest, who gets off lowest. This Alabama defense right now is locked in, playing with a lot of confidence. They love the challenge of going into the swamp. And if I'm Alabama coming into this, Pete Golding, the defensive coordinator, blow up this running game. Make the quarterbacks throw to beat me. I have such confidence in the back end. Get these quarterbacks to 3rd and 6, 3rd and 8. Disguise, show them blitz, back out. Disguise blitz, come. Make their heads spin. That's exactly what Alabama's defense will do today.
I expect to see a lot of AR-15. Richardson, the young quarterback.
He's healthy.
See if To'o can get him on the ground. There might be some collisions there.
Those
two big fellas in the swamp. Alabama and Florida, big SEC game coming up.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.